Welcome students. So in today's lecture we are going to continue our essay The Convalescent written by Charles Lamb. How sickness enlarges the dimensions of a man's self to himself. Now Lamb says that sickness enlarges the dimensions of a man's self to himself. Dimensions means vistar or seema. Okay. So he says due to the sickness a person can become self-centered, because during sickness he can only think about himself. He is his own exclusive object and he is his own exclusive means only, object means uddeshya or aim, and you can also say focus. Okay, now he is his only aim or focus. Supreme selfishness is inculcated upon him as his only duty. Supreme means highest, and selfishness is a person who is only concerned about himself. Swarthi. Okay. So, supreme selfishness is forced. Inculcated means forced upon him as his only duty. He becomes highly selfish during sickness. And he is now only concerned about himself. It is the two tables of the law to him. Now here there is a biblical reference. Okay, first these two tables. Now first table was about our relationship with God, and the second table was about our relationship to man. So in brief you can say that here it means that how a sick person should behave or what he should follow. Okay. He has nothing to think of but how to get well. He has nothing to think of but how to get well. He should only think about getting well or getting healthy soon. What passes out of doors or within them, so he hear not the jarring of them, affects him not. Now who is getting out or who is getting in, he should not bother. Okay, and he should not care about that. He does not hear the jarring means a harsh sound. Okay, of these doors, and it affects him not. That means a sick person does not care who is getting in and who is getting out. He does not even hear the sound of opening and closing the doors. A little while ago, he was greatly concerned in the event of a lawsuit, which was to be the making or the marrying of his dearest friend. Now he says that a little while ago, he was very concerned about a court case. Lawsuit means a court case when he was not sick. Okay, because this court case was going to make or mar. Mar means to destroy. Because this court case was to make or to destroy the life of his dearest friend. That is why he was so concerned about it. Okay. That means when he was not sick, his focus was on a court case that concerned his good friend or his dearest friend. And this case was going to affect the life of his friend very much. That is why he was really concerned about that court case. Okay. He was to be seen trudging about upon this man's errand to 50 quarters of the town at once, jogging the witness, refreshing the solicitor. Now he says that at that time, then he was seen trudging means walking heavily. Okay, here and there for this man's errand, for his friend's errand. Errand means work or his task. Okay, so at that time he was seen walking here and there for this man's work. Errand to 50 quarters of the town at once, jogging this witness, refreshing that solicitor. He was seen going to 50 quarters means houses. Okay, so he was seen going to 50 houses of the town to jogging. Jogging means to revive memory of his witnesses. Witnesses is gawah. Okay. Or to refresh. Refresh means to revitalize the solicitor. Solicitor means lawyers, wakil. Okay. Or to refresh the lawyers of his case. In short, you can say that he was working really hard for his friend's court case. Okay. The cause was to come on yesterday and result of this case was to come on yesterday. He is absolutely as indifferent to the decision as if it were a question to be tried at Peking. So, but now he is completely indifferent. Indifferent means not interested at all. Okay. So, now he is completely not interested in the decision of this court case as if it was useless for him. Because now he is ill and he is not concerned about anything but himself. Peradventure, from some whispering going on about the house not intended for his hearing, he picks up enough to make him understand that things went cross-grained in the court yesterday and his friend is ruined. Peradventure means perhaps, shayad, okay? Perhaps from some whispering, perhaps he will get to know about the result of the case from the whispering in the house. Whispering yani fusfusahat, okay? So, probably he will get to know about the result of the case from the whispering in the house because other members of his house were talking about the result of this case, okay? So, perhaps he will get to know about the result of the case from the whispering in the house. Although this whispering about the case was not intended for his hearing. Intended means uddeshya hona, okay? He picks up enough to make him understand that things went cross-grained in the court yesterday. Cross-grained means contrary, okay? But he heard enough to understand that the decision of the case went against his friend and now his friend is ruined. Ruined means destroyed, okay? But the word friend and the word ruin disturb him no more than so much jargon. But still, the word friend and the word ruin does not disturb him. They are just some words from some jargon. Jargon means code lingo. That means some special language, okay? For him, that he cannot understand because he is sick. That is why he is not at all concerned about his friend right now, okay? He is not to think of anything but how to get better. All he can think about is how to get better soon, okay? What a world of foreign cares are merged in that absorbing consideration. In this interesting thought, absorbing consideration means interesting thought, okay? In this interesting thought, a whole world of foreign concerns are merged, means mixed together, okay? He has put on the strong armor of sickness. He has put on the strong armor. Armor means kavach or cover, you can say. He has put on the strong cover of sickness. He is wrapped in the callous hide of suffering. Now he is covered in a hard cover of suffering. Callous means hard, okay? Hide means cover. Now he is wrapped. Wrapped means covered in a hard cover of suffering. Hard cover of suffering, because he is sick and he is suffering, then no one blame him of being indifferent toward sensitive things, okay? That is how his sickness becomes his cover or armor. He keeps his sympathy like some curious vintage under trusty lock and key for his own use only. He does not show his sympathy with others very easily. He keeps it like a curious. Curious means some precious or extraordinary. And vintage means wine. So he keeps his his sympathy like a precious wine under lock and key. That means he does not show his sympathy towards others very easily, and he uses this sympathy for himself only. That means he becomes insensitive towards others' suffering, and he is now only concerned about himself. He lies pitying himself, honing and moaning to himself. He lies on his sick bed, pitying himself. Pity means daya karna. Okay. He lies on his sick bed, pitying himself. Honing and moaning. Honing means to murmur. Okay. Badbadana. Murmuring and moaning means crying. Murmuring and crying on his own condition. He yearned over himself and he desires, yearn means to desire. He desires to get well soon and to get his health back. His bowels are even melted within him and he feels as if his bowels means intestines, ante jise kehte hain, or some inner organs of his body. He feels as if his bowels are even melted within him due to his sickness. To think what he suffers, he is not ashamed to weep over himself, and he only thinks about his suffering, and he is not even ashamed to weep over his condition. He is forever plotting how to do some good to himself, studying little stratagems and artificial alleviations. He is now ever planning to do some good for himself. And he is always thinking about stratagems. Stratagems means schemes. Okay. He is always thinking about schemes for himself. And artificial alleviation. And he also thinks about some artificial alleviations means some healing or remedies for himself. He makes the most of himself, dividing himself by an allowable fiction into as many distinct individuals as he hath sore and sorrowing members. Now he does everything for himself, okay, and he divides himself according to a tolerable amount of imagination. Fiction means most of himself. Fiction means imagination. Okay, so this sick person divides himself in according to a tolerable amount of imagination. Allowable means to a right amount or to a tolerable amount of imagination. Okay, suitable, you can say, into as many distinct individuals as he had sore and sorrowing members. He divides himself into different separate individuals according to the number of painful body parts. That means he imagines that each of his painful body part is behaving like an individual, okay, and they are his sorrowing members because each of these body parts is in pain due to the illness or due to the fever. Sometimes he meditates as of a thing apart from him upon his poor aching head and that dull pain which dozing or waking lay in it all the past night like a log or palpable substance of pain. Now he says that he thinks, meditate means to think, okay, he thinks upon these parts as if they are apart. Apart means alag hona, as if they are apart from him, and he thinks about his poor aching head. Aching means dard hona, okay, and he thinks about his poor aching head. He thinks about that dull pain from which he was suffering the whole past night, okay, dozing and waking, and he was suffering from this pain while sleeping, and he was suffering from it while waking up. It was like a wooden log, like a log or a palpable substance of pain. This pain was like a wooden log or a substance of pain that is touchable, okay. Palpable means something that you can feel by touching. It was so real that you can feel it by touching that body, particular body part. Okay. Not to be removed without opening the very skull. Skull means khopdi. Okay. And it was so intense that it seemed as if it could not be removed from his head without opening the very skull. Skull means khopdi. Okay. And only by opening his skull, you could take this pain from there. Dance means from there, okay? Or he pities his long, clammy, attenuated fingers. Sometimes he pities over. Pities means daya dikhana. And he sometimes pities over his long, clammy. Clammy means chip-chipa. Attenuated means thin. Or patli fingers, and sometimes he shows pity over his long, clammy, thin fingers. He compassionates himself all over, and his bad is a very discipline of humanity and tender heart. Now he sympathizes himself and he learns to show humanity and soft heart or tenderness of heart, okay, on his sick bed. He is his own sympathizer and he becomes his own sympathizer. Sympathize means sahanubhuti, okay? And instinctively feels that none can so well perform that office for him. Instinctively means naturally, okay? And he naturally assumes that no one can perform that office. Office here it means role, okay? And no one can perform that role for him. That means no can show sympathy towards him. That is why he himself is showing sympathy towards him. Okay. He cares for few spectators to his tragedy. Spectators means visitors. Okay. And he does not want many visitors for himself on his tragedy. Only that punctual face of the old nurse pleases him. But he only feels happy by seeing that punctual old nurse that announces his broths and his cordials, because she brings for him broths. Broths means soups, okay, and cordials. Cordials means a kind of drink, okay, because this old nurse brings for him some soups and cordials. He likes it because it is so unmoved and because he can pour forth his feverish ejaculations before it as unreservedly as to his bedpost. And he likes it because it is unmoved, that means unchanged, and he can share his feverish release of emotions. Ejaculations means release of emotions freely and openly in front of her, and she always listens to him and about his troubles. That is all for today's lecture. We will continue our essay in our next video. Thank you.